procedure for controlling a ViewMarq via Modbus for most PLCs would be to send the messages of Modbus write, then when that's complete, use a read instruction to do a bunch of Modbus reads of the ViewMarq command block to see when a ViewMarq is finished, and then finally, read the reply status block to see if the result is okay. If so, then everything's ready to go. If not, then there was an error. The good news is, you don't have to do any of that with a Productivity 3000. It has a built-in ViewMarq instruction that does all of that message transfer and error checking for you. Let's take a look. Let's start a brand new project and open up the hardware configuration. Make sure the controller is in stop mode, and then hit this button to auto-discover all of your hardware. This dialog is warning me that this PLC doesn't match my project. We know that, so we'll tell it to ignore all of these messages. And here's our system. If we double-click on that, we can see that we have a small base with a processor and an input simulator. Now we just double-click on the CPU to configure it. We're going to connect to the ViewMarq via the serial port in this video, but if you're using the Ethernet port, you would simply click on that tab. Over here in the serial port tab, we just need to match the settings that are on the ViewMarq. Our ViewMarq is operating at 38.4. It's at address 1, odd parity, 8 data bits, 1 stop bit. Perfect. Over in the ViewMarq software, go ahead and establish communications between the PC and the ViewMarq. Our Productivity 3000 project will be using serial Modbus, so let's set this to the same thing. Modbus, 38.4, odd, 1, and 8. Once we've configured that connection, we can now go check out the LED display configuration. Since we're connected via serial, we want to make sure we're talking Modbus, we have the right parameters, and for this demo, we'll turn on the diagnostic LED. Well, now that the hardware is set up, the software is trivial. We just drop a ViewMarq instruction in place. Let's scroll down until we find it, right here. Drop it on the rung, and fill in the blanks. We're using the serial port, so we select that. The node address of the ViewMarq is 1, that's correct. Next, we grab our ViewMarq string by pressing copy, and then we paste it in here. And then finally, we need to define a tag for the syntax response. And let's call that the ViewMarq reply. So we set up our serial port, we pasted our string in, and we set up the one required tag. Hit OK. The software recognizes that we created a new tag. It says, do we want it to go ahead and create that tag? The answer is yes, but I'm going to go ahead and expand the length of this to 128 characters to give the ViewMarq plenty of room to reply. Let's add a contact to enable this message. We'll use the input simulator, so let me go back to the hardware configuration. Double-click on my input simulator, and let's define this first switch as our message enable. Now that we've done that, we can place a contact over here, and we can enable this instruction by flipping that switch on the front of the input simulator. Note this little arrow right here on the ViewMarq instruction. That tells me this is an edge-triggered instruction, so the rising edge of this contact will enable this instruction, and then it will run to completion over several scans all by itself. You don't have to worry about it. Let's go ahead and transfer our project over to the P3000. Now I'm going to reach down to the input simulator and flip that enable switch we just set up, and there's our message. Easy. So all we did was set up the Productivity 3000 hardware, set up the ViewMarq hardware, drop a ViewMarq instruction on the screen, and fill in the blanks. And that's all there is to it. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Let us know if you have any questions. Automation Direct's customer support is always free and just a phone call or email away. Performance plus value. That's productivity from Automation Direct.